seems like y'all got off to a good start and slowly lost the momentum. Was there something that happened? Was there something that was said at halftime? Because it seemed like y'all tried to come back and it just didn't happen.
I think that we just, you know, we had a pretty decent first half. You know, we got down by four, I think. And I just feel like in the second half, we didn't come out with the right mentality.
Yeah, piggyback on what Black said, you know, we just got to learn from this, come out with a different mindset, and just keep pushing.
For both of you guys, obviously Coach Green says you guys practice a lot on three-point shooting practice. You know, when you're in a shooting slump like this, how do you explain, is it more of like a mental thing, or you know, how do you explain what goes into being poor from the three-point?
Well, you know, it's really just each individual, how they take on that. So with me, you know, it's like just gotta keep pushing, you know, keep praying, keep getting up shots after practice, and you know, they'll ball.
I think it's just staying confident in yourself. You know, we like you said, we're getting a little shooting slump, and I have too. So it's just making sure you just stand in the gym, believing in yourself. The coaching staff, they always push us and just make sure we get up extra reps, and they always they're pushing us to just stay confident, just keep shooting.
For both of y'all, you know, you talked all year about coming out of halftime with the same mentality we have in the first half, but you know, it's something that keeps happening over and over again. You know, one, why do you think that is, that it keeps happening over and over? And two, does it get frustrating at any point?
Oh yeah, it definitely gets frustrating. It's just I can't tell you exactly what it is. It just seems to be our Achilles heel right now, and something that we really need to just work on. So you know, we'll get back to it tomorrow.
Everything you do, you know, it's just really learning, seeing your mistakes, and we see that right now, coming out of halftime, it's not our strong suit, but before the season end, I can see that we can turn that into one of our biggest things.
Turtle, how well do you know Ashton Hagens? I know he was a commitment here for a long time, so I assume you saw him coming through, and what kind of problems, how frustrating was it, you know, having to deal with him, especially knowing that, you know, he was one of you guys for a while?
Well, you know, going into it, we didn't really emphasize anything about Ashton's commitment to here. You know, his decision to go to Kentucky, you know, is based on him. So, really wasn't anything personal or anything. You know, I don't really know him like that off the court. But, you know, as the game, you know, he's a great player in a great program. And, you know, we wish the best for him.
I guess just for both players, when you got a sellout crowd like that and you lose by 20, I mean, is it an anger? Is it a frustration? I mean, you look calm and collected here. What was the locker room like after an ESPN game?
No, it's not anger, anything like that. You know, it's just a motivation, you know. You got to take everything that God gives you and just keep pushing. Do everything in personal life, on and off the court, no matter what happens. If you wanted to go one way and it goes the other way, you're going to keep pushing, because I still believe by the end of this season, you know, make a lot of believers out of this team, and Coach Green is a great coach. His system is awesome, man. We're really just blessed to be in this opportunity to come up here and play this beautiful game, and you know, take this as a motivation.
Another sellout crowd coming up on Saturday. What can you take from tonight to improve and get a win on Saturday against the Gators?
It seemed like something that we've been saying a lot, but we had to bounce back. Team to stay confident in ourselves. The crowd was behind us the whole game, and we didn't perform like we were supposed to, but we'll be ready for Saturday, and you know, we expect to have them with us the whole game.
Yeah, with Saturday, you know, we just really come up with a mindset to win, like every game. No matter the outcome, we're gonna get raw, we're gonna listen to coach, and really just make our families proud.
Was there anything that you all specifically noticed in this game that maybe personally you need to focus on more in practice or as a team?
I would say we need to do a better job of just, you know, playing defense as a whole. You know, we had some guys for them come out and play very well, so we need to do a better job of just stopping them. It's pretty simple, and we need to make sure we knock down shots. That's me, that's everybody, you know. So we just gotta look ourselves in the mirror. It's not the coach, it's the player. We gotta come out and just gotta fight and just keep getting better.
Yeah, I mean, personally, like you said, from this game, what we saw that we might have to work on, you know, it's really, right now, after a loss like this, you have to really individually. as you look at yourself and every aspect, even if you play well, shooting or defense, you know, you just got to just try to improve everything. When we have practice on Thursday, we're going to go hard. We try to just keep motivating everyone, make sure we get class on time on Wednesday and get ready for Saturday.
The two worst shooting performances you guys had this year, coming two of the best teams you played, you know, Kentucky and Tennessee. Now that you've had a couple games like that, what have you noticed that, you know, the top teams this league are doing to kind of keep you guys quiet on offense?
Well, you know, like my mom said, if you had the rock bottom, you can always go up. So if people claim that it's our worst game, then you have to see the next time we might face them or face another great opponent. I don't think that we'll do much better. So we can't really have our heads down or anything like that. No one on Dawg Nation should have the head down, even if it was a loss, because you know, if you lose by one or you lose by 20, it's still a loss. And we're going to take that as, like I keep saying, like a motivation. So, yes.
Any more questions?